Thanks, Dave. And we're here now with David Yonkai from the LULAC Political Letter. He's getting us up to speed on everything politics. David, is always fantastic having you here.
Happy to be here. Thank you.
So let's start. We're going to cover a couple of topics, lightning round style. And first up, the Brexit, which is the slang, of course, for Britain deciding to leave the European Union. How does that impact American elections?
Well, I think it's going to impact American elections because you don't get a do-over when you vote. And I think there are many people in Britain who are very unhappy with the way that they voted. And you know, in an election campaign, there's noise. And you hear noise, but you also have to listen. And I think that it's a cautionary tale for people in America in this presidential election to make sure you not only hear the noise, but listen to what the candidates are saying, and more importantly, what they're not saying.
So don't just brush something off as a trivial thing. You're saying listen very carefully. And now, speaking of listening, I know a lot of people have been listening very closely to the congressional report having to do with Hillary Clinton and Benghazi. And related to that, Bill Clinton met with Attorney General Loretta Lynch on the tarmac in Arizona. What's your take on this?
Well, my take on that is I bet you the Clinton campaign and Hillary Clinton is wishing that he met one of his old girlfriends on the tarmac rather than the Attorney General. I mean, really, his wife is under investigation, but you know, Bill Clinton is a people pleaser, and he held the plane to meet with Loretta Lynch, and it's mystifying to me why his staff people didn't say, Mr. President, you know, you don't do this. The Attorney General staff person said, you don't do this. I think that if, you know, she has a good outcome, the conspiracy theorists are gonna say, they met on the tarmac.
So it causes some talk where there didn't necessarily need to be talk.
It's an unnecessary political problem that was created, and I'd like to be a fly on the wall when he came home that night because it just was unnecessary.
Well, certainly interesting to see how everything comes out. And then the GOP convention is kicking off in just a couple weeks in July in Cleveland. What do you think we're going to see there?
I think what you're not going to see, you're not going to see a lot of traditional Republicans on the floor of the convention. In Cleveland, there's a rib place called the Tic Tac Tavern on Euclid Avenue. I think you're going to see more traditional Republicans there than you would on the convention floor.
Seriously, is that just because of...
They're not happy with the Trump campaign and they want to try to send a message. John Kasich, who ran against him, he's hosting the convention as the governor. And he may not show up. I mean, he'll be on the outskirts, but I'm not sure that he'll come in.
And here in Pennsylvania, the legislature seems to be putting aside their differences to work on passing a state budget. How is this different from last year?
All about the election. Tom Wolf wants to make a good impression. He's the host governor for the Democratic convention. And those guys are up for re-election.
Okay, so it's they're working on working together, hopefully.
Exactly.
Politics
right.
Maybe not completely broken.
Without.
I love
without
it. All right.
Doubt.
And every time you're on, David, you always wear a new, very exciting tie. I have to ask you about your tie this time.
This is a Declaration of Independence tie, July 4th, big holiday. And let me just say another thing. There's another big anniversary coming up, your first anniversary on PA Live. It's closing in on a year, so I just want to congratulate you.
Is it really? You see, you have me beat. That's... Well, thanks for recognizing
not
that.
Not a problem at all. Not a problem at all.
How time flies.
Yeah.
And David, where can we go if we want to get more information?
LULACPoliticalLetter.blogspot.com. We're also going to be tweeting during the conventions at LULACPolLetter on Twitter.
All right. So everything politics and more, that's where you can get it. David Yonkai, as always, thank you so much for joining us.
Happy to be here. Thank you.